Today, the Toyota Research Institute TRI announced a generative artificial intelligence AI method to help vehicle designers. At present, designers can use freely accessible text-to-image generative AI technologies as an initial stage in their creative process. The innovative method developed by TRI enables designers to incorporate initial design sketches and engineering limitations into this procedure, reducing the number of iterations required to balance design and engineering issues. Avinash Balachandran, director of TRI's Human Interactive Driving HID division, led the team that developed the technology. Generative AI tools are often used as inspiration for designers, but they cannot handle the complex engineering and safety considerations that go into actual car design, he stated. The cutting-edge capabilities of contemporary generative AI are combined with the long-standing engineering strengths of Toyota in this technique. To research papers from TRI, researchers explain how the technique applies precise technical limitations to the design process. Now it is possible to implicitly include constraints like drag, which affects fuel efficiency, and chassis parameters such as ride height and cabin size, which affect handling, ergonomics, and safety in the generative AI process. The researchers connected text-to-image-based generative AI to optimization theory principles, which are frequently employed in computer-aided engineering. With the help of the resulting algorithm, the designer can keep their text-based style cues for the generative AI process while still optimizing engineering limitations. For instance, while also maximizing a numerical performance indicator, a designer can text prompt a set of designs with particular stylistic characteristics like sleek, SUV-like, and modern based on an initial prototype concept. The group specifically addressed aerodynamic drag in the research article. The strategy can also improve any additional performance indicators or restrictions deduced from a design image. According to Charlene Wu, senior director of TRI's Human-Centered AI-HCAI division, whose team worked with the Human Interactive Driving team on this project, TRI is harnessing the creative power of AI to amplify automobile designers and engineers. This tool may potentially assist Toyota in designing electrified vehicles more rapidly and effectively by directly bringing engineering restrictions into the design process. Takeru Kato, president of the Toyota Motor Corporation's BEV facility, stated that lowering drag is essential for enhancing the aerodynamics of BEVs and maximizing their range. Likewise, Toyota employs generative design to produce a seat frame that is secure, light, attractive, and sustainable for the future of comfortable car interiors. Adding more space to a limited place is particularly challenging in the difficult art of combining the design, safety, and comfort of automobiles. With the development of lighter, thinner seats, Toyota is addressing consumer desire for increased interior space. Shinsuke Mori, project manager in the Interior Design Department, Vision Design Division at Toyota Motor Corporation, states that although the existing seat frame is created to match the strength requirement with trusted manufacturability, it is challenging to make it thinner. Designers typically add materials to the seat frame rather than alter it directly, and this is the limitation. However, the designer Mato Mori doesn't have to worry about the shape of showroom car frames when considering the ideal forms and characteristics for seats. This time, despite the fact that it is still a developing technology, Mori explains, "We wanted to design a new frame that can influence and also connect to commercial cars in the near future. This project is just for advanced development if the designers don't think it's possible. In order to some extent, we had to make it practical. In addition to other considerations, ensuring occupant safety and comfort must be a priority when designing seats for fast-moving vehicles. The complexity of this endeavor is increased by sustainability and weight reduction. The balance between comfort, sustainability, weight loss, and design is the current area of emphasis, according to Mori. The AI-based generative design tool, which is a part of Autodesk Fusion 360, is a fantastic fit for this juggling act. I thought it was interesting when I realized that generative design was being used in race car suspensions," explains Mori. "The fact that technology may generate shapes that human designers would never have considered, yet the requirements are met, so the cars are light and sturdy. I believe we could make it both old and modern by cherry-picking and balancing design elements that designers would not have included in a drawing with a solid background that satisfies all of our standards. Making a plan to provide extra room in the cabin was the first step in designing the new seat frame. The typical rectangular seat frame has a flat construction, but the designers experimented with moving the frame's core structure to the middle of the frame to see whether it would improve the frame's performance. The crew aimed to make the excluded area larger to ensure a broader space in front of their legs, since passengers in the back seats perceive a thick, wall-like seat in front of them as making the room feel smaller. The seat frame must be extremely rigid and strong to ensure automobile seat safety. In the event of a collision, passengers are propelled with enormous force, seat belts are pulled tight, and powerful forces are applied to specific places from various angles. The front seat may occasionally be struck by passengers in the back. When these specifications are provided, the generative design's result is often completely unexpected at first, according to Omori. But we expanded on it and made a few minor changes as we went. In other instances, the output's proportions and balance didn't initially appear to be beautiful, so we sought to purposefully steer the design in a particular way by making little tweaks to excluded regions. He goes on to say that there is always a trade-off between what a designer wants to do and what generative design develops. The design took 3 to 4 months to complete, and Omori collaborated closely with Satoshi Yanagisawa of Triple Bottom Line to complete the calculations. For instance, changing ratio or balance will result in problems in dynamics or increases in weight. The different patterns and shapes that designers don't consider are amusing, according to Omori. I'm fascinated by it constantly. One benefit of generative design, in my opinion, is the ability to produce items that are lightweight despite the fact that doing so also requires understanding of the relevant fields and materials. It is amazing and fascinating to watch how minor variations may produce entirely different shapes. A specific part's weight can be decreased using all of these inputs. In order to create new design utilizing generative design, the team is now collaborating with internal engineers. Omori claims that the team is creating the seat frame with the potential to include it in a finished product. This seat frame must be produced using 3D printing, which raises the price. As existing seat frames are effectively produced using well-established manufacturing techniques, more research is required to determine how to create the frame using press manufacturing while simultaneously applying generative design principles. He says, "I think there are chances to make it happen as we have learned a lot from this initiative." Omori asserts that the value of mass-producing goods using presses may change in the future for automobiles. It's challenging to create something that is ideal and pleasant for everyone, he claims, because today's seats are designed with the greatest common denominator in mind to fit a range of body proportions. With this type of innovative design, it might be possible to create the rest of the seat to fit the user's body using a 3D printer, for example, while keeping the spine of the seat the same for different seat sizes. The existing chairs are constructed from a variety of materials, including metal frames, urethane, and leather, but according to Omori, generative design may make nanomaterials obsolete. He asserts that this kind of design would be simpler to implement if it were initially employed for a specific objective. For instance, if we restrict it to low-speed mobility, we may reduce the requirements. I believe we might begin with that as a first step, and then progressively introduce regular automobiles if there is a unique environment where speed is automatically controlled. Toyota is aggressively experimenting with AI-based techniques for its design pipeline, such as generative design. In this place, Omori claims, we are very free to do that. We create and plan for things unrelated to autos in the same department. It's crucial to be inspired by several departments and other things. In the future, these instruments will shift our attention, and the fundamental idea will take on greater significance. In order to stand out, we must narrow our attention to the type of shape we want to produce and the goal, significance, and purpose that underlies it. Having said that, what do you think of the new strategy of Toyota utilizing AI generative tools in redesigning Toyota cars and also using the famous GigaPress in the future? Let us know your thoughts in the comment box below. If you've watched up to this point, thank you so much. For more videos about EVs, Toyota, Tesla, Ford, and the most recent auto news, please consider subscribing to Tech Addicts.